Today, you are listening to Think Again Christian, where pop culture and Christian traditions collide with biblical truth. Sponsored by Rainier Christian Schools. And now your host, pastor of Ravensdale Bible Church and superintendent of Rainier Christian Schools, Tony Jamie.
Rethinking, re-examining concepts, ideas, traditions, and beliefs in our culture and Christian circles. Today we're going to talk about a worthy investment. What is a worthy investment? Well, how much time do you think about finances or financial gains? Especially during an election year, right? We always take a look and ask that question, are we better off today than we were 4 or 8 years ago? Are you keeping tabs of your investments? I mean, radio shows, almost always have some kind of, financial investment advertising. The billboards all over town are financial investments. And as you get older, you just think more and more about these things. Am I prepared for the future? Well, living in America, it's very difficult to not be stressed out about getting, keeping, and saving money. I mean, I understand. I'm right there with everybody else. So, I have 5 children, 2 are in college, 3 more coming. And so, we all think about the best way to spend or invest our money to where it yields more production. Well, today I want to talk about a worthy investment. And again, please don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that investing for your financial future isn't a worthy investment, but I want to talk about something a little bit different. I want to talk about investing in Christian education. Investing in Christian education. Do you realize that the United States is rapidly becoming the most ignored mission field in the world? From small cities in the Northeast to small farm towns scattered across the Central Plains, to isolated logging communities out west to South King County, North America is the only continent where Christianity is not growing. How can that be? I remember going to seminary and meeting several seminarians and students from all over the world, and they had a mentality of they were coming here to America to evangelize to us. And you think, wait a minute, we're the ones who are supposed to go out across the oceans and evangelize. Yet we seem to have forgotten about communities that are often only minutes away from us and from our churches. And we have a way to reach them without crossing the ocean and without learning another language. And that's through local Christian schools. Because our children here in America desperately need the gospel. Now, hundreds of years of missions used to focus on foreign fields, and they produced amazing harvests of souls and have transformed communities and nations. It's been an awesome thing. We've gone across the seas and ministered to orphanages and turned those orphanages into schools, and we've been very successful with that model. But here in America, we're declining. About 12 churches for every 10,000 people are closing every year. The average church size is under 90 in America right now, and they're struggling to survive. And yet Christian schools are right there hoping to fill that void, not replacing the church. Remember when Jesus left, he didn't leave us behind a Christian school, right? He left us a church. But to come alongside and support the church. But here's the thing. Economic times and rising costs are making it very difficult for Christian families to send their children to Christian schools. Like any parachurch ministry, Christian schools heavily depend and desperately need your help. The common misconception is that the families who attend these churches are affluent and wealthy and have lots of money, and that the schools are fully funded. And that's just not the case. So let's think about a worthy investment, a worthy place to put your money. Have you ever considered investing or putting capital into a school in order to yield a spiritual gain? Have you ever considered backing a local school, that Christian school that, you know, you didn't attend or your children didn't attend, but you just support their mission, their ministry. Today, I want to talk about some of the reasons why Christian schools need your help, because maybe you're not familiar with them, and you've driven by them, and maybe you've, you know, been to Krista and you've seen this just gorgeous campus here at King's, and you think to yourself, well, there's no way they need any money. But the first concept that I want you to think about is the teachers. See, the teachers in America, the Christian teachers in America, are really our heroes. They are missionaries next door. They're right next door to you. They live in your town. And when we think about the typical missionary, we think about somebody who sacrifices money, who sacrifices prestige, who is willing to give up material things to go overseas, to go into a community, to make an impact on children, to make an impact in families, and to do that through Christian education. Sometimes they use hydration or food or medical care, but quite often it's through education. And it takes a little while for them to learn the language and the culture. And, you know, it takes about 5 years. And, you know, if they're lucky and they have 30 students or, you know, 30 people in a church plant, then that's a great success. And praise God for those endeavors. Praise the Lord for that. That's an awesome thing. But imagine what could be done right here, right here. And our teachers actually make great financial sacrifices to teach here in America. And it's hard because you're trying to keep up with the Joneses too. You've got bills to pay. The mortgage company doesn't care. You know, the appraiser doesn't care that you work at a Christian school. And so our Christian teachers who across the nation have an average salary of about $25,000, no benefits, no retirement, extra hours, extra tasks. And yet we just consider them workers. These are our modern day missionaries. And part of the reasons why we need to get better in Christian education is we need to compensate our teachers more so that they can stay with us, so that we can get more and attract more Christian educators, get them, and then keep them. Secondly, our families, they need financial support. I mean, most Christian families have, you know, 2.5, 3.5 children. So imagine at $6,000 a year and you're trying to send your children to third, fourth grade, that's going to be $18,000. You know, most people don't have discretionary funds of $18,000. And so they can't go to a private Christian school. You know, at Rainier Christian Schools, our financial aid is, you know, we don't have this treasure box full of money. It's not fully funded. And so our financial aid program that we desperately need to give discounts to our families, especially with multiple children, really just comes right out of our own pockets. And then every year I'm faced with parents who come into my office and are trying to make a decision of which child gets to come to our school and which one doesn't. It breaks my heart every time. Because they're trying to make those decisions really solely based on finances. And so we have an opportunity to join together. We have an opportunity to all be involved in this great mission field. And I'm not just talking about Rainier Christian Schools. Please don't get me wrong. I love our school and would love for anybody in the Seattle area to support our school. But I'm talking about Christian education across the board, wholesale. Do we think about Christian education as a mission field? And do we think of America as a mission field? And do we think about the idea and the concept that this is a great way for us to reach those who are lost? One of my passages that I go to when I think about this endeavor, this concept is Jesus. Jesus began the tradition of sending out local missionaries, when he sent his disciples out to the local villages without food or money. They had nothing in their purse. They relied on the full support of those who shared the common vision for the same ministry, for the love of Jesus Christ. And so Jesus himself ministered within only a 30-mile radius, just a 30-mile radius of his birthplace and his death site. Ironically, at Rainier Christian Schools in the South King County, Kent, Maple Valley, Renton area, we serve about 30 square miles, which when I look around and I visualize and I think about it, it's like, wow, that's incredible. That's only the space that Jesus ministered to, and we share that same distance. See, distance, as far as how far you go, really has nothing to do with missionary work. One of my favorite schools is in Seattle. And it's called the Seattle Urban Academy, and they partner actually with Seattle's Union Gospel Mission, with Krista Ministries, and with you. Many of you listeners have supported them financially. And what I love about it is they've been able to take the average cost, which is usually anywhere from, you know, $4,000 to $10,000 for a private Christian school. And because of donations and because of partnerships, they have that down to about $500 a semester. That's unbelievable to be able to provide a quality Christian education for those who need it the most. And what I love is that it's us, it's the church, it's the believers that join together in making this investment. We make this investment in these children so that they can grow and live prosperous Christian lives. The cool thing about the Seattle Urban Academy is that most of those students are actually students that are on their way out of school. And so these aren't the straight A students. These aren't the students that come from the most affluent families in the area. These are actually the lower tier that are flunking out of school, on their way out, not going to graduate high school. And by the time they go through the Seattle Urban Academy, last time I checked, and you know, I don't work for them, so I don't have all the numbers, but Their graduation rate was 91%, and their college rate was 87%. Those are unbelievable numbers. And what an amazing way to reach these children through the gospel by preaching and teaching Jesus Christ to them every single day and using education as the tool. There's a lot of ways to skin the cat. We use a lot of different methods to reach people for the gospel, but I think Christian education is the best way to go. And when we come back, we'll talk more about that.
Since their small beginnings in 1963, the ministry of Rainier Christian Schools has been dedicated to educating and developing each of their students for the glory of God. And it's more than just a school. Rainier Christian Schools is actually an entire school district, with three schools serving the areas of Kent, Auburn, Covington, Renton, and Maple Valley. The Christ-centered environment weaves God's truth through everything they do, from top-notch academics all the way through their competitive sports programs. Learn more at RainierCSD.org or call 425-255-7273. That's 425-255-7273. Contact Rainier Christian Schools today.
Welcome back. You're listening to Think Again Christian, sponsored by Rainier Christian Schools. And now your host, Tony Jamie.
A worthy investment. A worthy investment. We think about investing, we think about getting a yield, getting a return on our money, making it grow. And has that idea of, you know, reaping what you sow, you know, planting a harvest and seeing the fruit, seeing the production. It's a really cool thing when you drive up the 5 freeway going through the San Joaquin Valley and you'll see, you know, just dirt for miles and miles. And then you see kind of the stages and maybe some grapes, you know, and they're just getting started. And then you see these just row after row after row of beautiful, delicious grapes and people picking them and the harvest is ripe, right? But the workers are few. And so part of that investment is we need more people involved. We need more people involved in actually the financial participation of the investment. And so today we're talking about a worthy investment. I've been very, very blessed to have been involved in a lot of different ministries, a lot of really awesome ministries, and the Lord's been gracious to me to let me be involved and to let me go down to Mexico and build, you know, little two-story bunkhouses, you know, the the little shed that you would park your lawnmower in, well, make that two stories tall and you've got a bunkhouse in Mexico. Still no lights, you know, no electricity, no running water, but a home for people. I've been able to be involved in Seattle's Union Gospel Mission, where we can take, you know, soup and sandwich and give them salvation, right? Give them a place to sleep at night and give them hot chocolate on a cold night. It's a great ministry. And yet we have so many different options to choose from. But for my money, I love Christian education. As a preacher, as a pastor, I get to preach to my flock, you know, once a week. Maybe if you're fortunate, you have a Sunday morning Sunday school class or a Wednesday night prayer group or a Thursday night Bible study. But you don't get them every single day. You don't get the congregation every single day. And so primarily you're lucky at church if you get 1 to 2 hours a week. Well, compare 1 to 2 hours a week with every single day, 170 days in the typical school year, times 6 hours, 5 days a week. There's a lot of time. There's a great opportunity to patiently just take your time to walk the children through the gospel, to preach and teach Jesus Christ, to model what Christianity is in a lot of different ways, and whether it's teachers or coaches or bus drivers, we just participate in this joint venture. You know, in the Kent Maple Valley Renton area where we serve at Rainier Christian Schools, there's approximately 50,000 school-age children. 50,000. Now, we serve about 550. Now, I'm sorry, but those are bad numbers. Those are bad numbers. I want to serve a couple thousand of those 50,000, a couple thousand of children that we can be in daily discipleship with. If I were to take the, you know, 500 students and, you know, they would be with us from kindergarten to 12th grade, that'd be about a 13-year period. That would mean we would have approximately 7,000 students that we would be rotating every 13 years through Rainier Christian Schools. Can you imagine a ministry of starting from kindergarten, you know, when they're crawling, right? And preaching and teaching Jesus Christ every single day. It reminds me of Psalm 1, that it will yield its fruit in season. And we are very, very blessed to see throughout the years, we see children coming to the Lord in so many different ways, on baseball fields, in chapels, in classrooms. We see foreign exchange students coming to the Lord. We see parents coming to the Lord. This is a great opportunity to reach people for the gospel, not only in your local community, but it extends throughout the world. We have a unique opportunity of bringing, you know, local missionaries, our teachers. Our teachers are missionaries. They're devoted to these students' lives. They find the different ways to teach the gospel. They carry on the great tradition of the Eric Liddells and the George Muellers and the Amy Carmichaels and the Hudson Taylors, and we use this educational force, this process, to preach the gospel to them, to teach them about the Bible, to teach them about Jesus Christ. And so while some have used, like I mentioned before, you know, dentistry or glasses or hydration or soccer balls or bunkhouses, we use education. It's just a tool. But it's a great way because, again, in education, we're talking about teaching and educating and developing young minds, and that's an essential thing in Christianity. We're losing the battle, the philosophical battle, the ideological battle. We're losing the battle because way too many of our people are influenced by the ways of the world. We you know, I was talking to my son and he was asking me about the effects of rap music and how, you know, rap music comes up out and all of a sudden the kids are copying the words they're saying. They don't even know what they're saying. They're using these terms that are really vile, and they don't know that what they're doing is mimicking sin. And so we want to be able to put them in an environment, put them in a place where they can actually hear music that glorifies and honors the Lord, and have Christian relationships as iron sharpens iron with other kids and other students. Our staff is devoted to praying for our students, and our staff thinks about our students in spiritual assessments, not just academic ones, and taking a look at the students and evaluating where those students are spiritually, and the different ways we can help through our mentorship programs, through special chapels. And so we look at our children individually, as we want every single one of them to grow in Christ. The mission field is so ripe. It's so ripe. But like any missionary, like any mission organization, we rely on financial support, as do all the other schools in the area, as do even the big schools. And I'm always amazed. You take a USC or a University of Washington, and they get millions upon millions of dollars, and they have endowments, and they still require and need donors. If they need donors, then most definitely you can understand how a small Christian organization or Christian school would need donors as well. And honestly, we can't survive, not just us, but others, we can't survive without your support. And so please prayerfully consider joining. Please consider, there's a lot of different schools that have, you know, fundraisers throughout the year. We typically have three fundraisers. We have a golf tournament, we have a fall banquet, we have a spring auction, and these are the three primary ways that we're able to raise support and raise funds. And everybody's welcome. Everybody's welcome. You could be from anywhere in the world, and just like me sitting at home in America, I can make a donation to the Philippines. We had a local missionary from our church that we supported, and she was a midwife, and it was a great ministry. Fantastic ministry in the Philippines that we could support from America. Imagine being in the Philippines and supporting Christian education. Wouldn't that be kind of a flipping of the script? And so when we talk about a worthy investment, a true investment requires time and or money. And so, as I mentioned, over the past 20 years, I've seen and been involved in many ministries, and I can't think of a better return on an investment than Christian education here in America. I've been on some committees that have sent away missionaries to foreign lands, and again, I'm thrilled that we were able to do it, but it was actually very expensive to send missionaries overseas. And I had a very good friend, and he went to Jordan. I have a lot of respect for him because, you know, in the Jordan, they kill Christians. It was dangerous for him and his wife and his young child to even walk the streets there. And yet, you know, it was quite costly to send him all the way across the sea to be in Jordan, whereas we could have taken that same investment and invested in a couple of students getting a Christian education, or a teacher being able to make more money to be able to stay at our school. And so please, again, don't get me wrong. I'm not suggesting that we don't go to Africa, or we don't go to the Dominican or other amazing places, but it's crazy to me that, and forgive me because I'm biased, I admit it, I'm biased, okay? It's crazy to me, though, that $90 million runs through the halls of World Vision, which is less than 5 miles from one of my schools. And another $20 million goes through the doors of the Union Gospel Mission to serve the homeless. And we struggle to keep our doors open right here in King County. This is an amazing opportunity to serve locally in your local community. And when I think about the mission, every time I was on the street, I would think, if we had just gotten to these people 10 years earlier. And that's what really drove me to Christian education, to lay the seed and the foundation so that people don't become homeless, so that they don't become addicts, so that they don't get to that place. And so I want to encourage you and make a special plea for Rainier Christian. We're in the beginning of our Thrive campaign, and our goal is simple. We want 1,000 supporters at $25 a pledge per month, And that would equal $300,000 per year. You may not have $300,000, but you probably have $25. And so please prayerfully consider that. And you can go to our website, and right there on the front page is an opportunity for our Thrive campaign. So please, before you invest in future savings or overseas missions, just think again about your local Christian school.
You've been listening to Think Again Christian, sponsored by Rainier Christian Schools and Tony Jamie. Rainier Christian Schools serves preschool through high school with 3 locations in the Renton, Maple Valley, Covington, Kent, and Auburn areas. For more information about Rainier Christian Schools, www.rainiercsd.org or call 425-255-7273.